Hi, readers, and welcome to chapter 13 of the text, The Young Warriors by V.S. Reed. Chapter 13, To the Rescue. Tommy and Johnny had been given a meal of warm milk and bammy. They had stretched themselves out on the floor of a hut and had at once fallen asleep. When at last they were awakened by John, the scout, they could not tell how long they had slept. They followed John back to the council house where Chief James and his counselors were assembled. The street in Mocha was now filled with Maroons, among whom were warriors armed and ready to march. Then Chief James said to Tommy and Johnny, "Our warriors are leaving for Mountain Top. I shall send and tell your parents that their two brave young warriors are safe and well. Is there anything else you would like us to tell them?" The boys looked at each other and a swift, silent conversation seemed to pass between them. "But sir," cried Tommy, "we want to go with the warriors. We must rescue Charlie and help to fight for our village." Chief James frowned. "You boys are tired. You cannot keep up with the march." "But we can, Chief. We had a very long rest," cried Johnny. "Moreover, we can show you where we hid the two fine English muskets." A roar of laughter came from the councilmen. "We can really use these two fine English muskets," the chief said. "But believe me, you did not sleep very long. My young rooster, only for a few minutes." "We are used to very little sleep, sir," Tommy said quickly. "Very well. We thought you would want to go back, but promise me that you will do whatever the war captain tells you," the boys promised. The young warriors left before daylight. Tommy and Johnny soon found what the chief had meant when he said they should do as they were told. For as soon as they had left the village, two warriors picked up the boys and swung them on their shoulders. The boys cried out that they would prefer to walk like the other warriors. But the war captain only laughed. "You would not be able to keep up with us. You did your share of walking last night, and yesterday, and the night before." "We don't want to be carried," Tommy said. "We are young warriors." "And as young warriors, you will remember that you cannot break a promise. You promised Chief James to do as you were told," the war captain said. It was not long before the boys saw that he was right. The Mocha warriors moved so rapidly that they could never have kept up with them. The Mocha soldiers did not go down the face of the cliff. They had a secret way which took them through the holes into the Talking Rock, until they entered a cave. Led by men bearing torches, they walked for a long time through caves, each of which was a picture of beauty in the light of the torches. Rivers had once flowed through them, cutting lovely lace-like patterns into the rocks. The sight thrilled Tommy and Johnny, for never before had they seen anything so wonderful. In Mountain Top, there were only small caves in which wild boars sometimes lived. The caves led out to the tall grass which the boys had crossed the day before. The group reached the river by early afternoon. Scouts who had been sent ahead reported that there were no redcoats nearby. "Get out the boats," the war captain ordered. The boys' eyes bulged when they saw what happened next. Using the blades of their swords and cutlasses, the Mocha Maroons scraped away the soft river mud near the root of a big cotton tree. There, packed with rushes to keep it clean inside, was a large canoe. It was a dugout that had been made from one large cotton tree. Moving on to page 99. "Where did this come from?" Tommy asked one of the warriors. He laughed at the look of wonder on Tommy's face and said, This is used for fishing, boy. We hide it here from the redcoats. When we want to fish, we just take it up and sail off. Then when we return, we cover it up again. With a couple of men rowing the boat back and forth, the warriors crossed the river and took to the forest. On they went swiftly but quietly. The boys spoke to the war captain as they reached the place where they had hidden the muskets. There was no cheering, for everyone had to be quiet, but the warriors looked at Tommy and Johnny with respect. They grinned and shook their heads. As they neared the valley in which the redcoats had encamped, the Moka army halted. They sent their scouts ahead to find the mountaintop men. The Moka Maroons did not make camps as the redcoats would have done. They did not sit around in the open. The war captain just held up his hand, palm out, and brought it down sharply. The warriors suddenly sank out of sight. It was as if the earth had swallowed them. The company lay in high grass and thicket until dusk. Then, at a low whistle from their captain, they were out again, ready to march. Before setting out, they waited until their scouts had returned. Not long afterwards, they joined up with the mountaintop men. This is the end of chapter 13.